should grow up someday, cause I got bills to pay. I can't be waking up at someone else's place. I know I drink too much, can't pay my rent this month. I should be saving up, but I just got paid. I'm broke but I'm ballin', don't know where we're going. We go in when we go out.
We are very excited.
Don't bother nobody. Off car drive, show up, show out. Bow in, bow out, go in, go out. So rock, we pull out. I got more diamonds. Ladies be the finest. Crush grapes.
Ooh, we'll be the wine.
Crush grapes. With the funky sound, Cigala got the London sound.
I should blow up, they say, stuck in my glory days. I know there's nothing wrong, it's just a passing phase. And when I've had my fun, I swear I'll be someone. I know that day will come, but I'm just gone.
The originality logo design goes to Genie. It's Activate. The runner-up for Masters 2019 with the product You Are. Of Masters 2019 with RCT.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome once again to this Be Online Master Summit. In order to have a smooth interaction, please know we will give some minutes at the end for a Q&A round. But if throughout the presentation there are any questions or comments, feel free to write them on the chat. My name is Pilar Riesgo, BEO sales representative, and I'm so happy and honored to be your host today. We are here with a special guest who will share some tips of how to analyze a business strength and harness as an advantage despite the situation. This means turning a crisis into opportunity, and more nowadays, which is the role of COVID in entrepreneurship. I'm glad to introduce Hector de la Peña. He holds a master's degree in public image, having the highest average, allowing him to earn the Imago Excellence title. Since then, he has focused in public image, sales, personal branding, persuasion, and crisis management. So with no further introduction, I will pass the microphone to Hector. So Hector, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Billy.
Thank you very much for that introduction. Hello, everyone. My name is Hector Huela Peña, and I'm going to talk to you about the role of COVID in entrepreneurship. So I'm going to share my screen right now so we can walk through this together. Give me just 1 second. There. Okay, so we all know what we are living. We know that COVID came to change the world, and we couldn't predict that. We didn't know this was going to happen. We didn't know that COVID was going to come and make his stay longer than it should, but it happened, okay? So now, what do we do as entrepreneurs? What do we do as businesses? What do we do as young entrepreneurs who wants to keep on business, but now have a new virus who is affecting our lives and our businesses? So our workshop today is about the role of COVID in entrepreneur. How can we play with it? How can we make it our friend, not our enemy? How can we put it as a part of our business and let it help us instead of destroy us? Okay, so I'm going to talk a little about myself just so you know who I am. And my name is Hector Hugo, I said it already. I have two businesses, which is number one, H Estrategias, which is a agency that helps women achieve their goals in their businesses, okay? We help them in every public image related thing that you could imagine, since a web page to social media, to how to communicate, lectures, making products, etc. And I also help other kind of women who wants to apply the public image tools to their businesses with conferences and all kind of products that you can imagine. I've worked with Google, I've worked with Royal Prestige, I've worked with Moroccan Oil, which are very, very, very successful companies around the world. So that's who I am. But the thing here is that even for people who was already on business or was already selling their products or services, COVID came as a game changer because it changed everything. And you're going to hear me say today, change a lot of times, okay? So keep that in mind because it's a time for change. We are changing, everything is changing. So the COVID changed everything, especially our customer, okay? That person who bought from you last year may not be the person who is going to buy from you this year, at this moment, okay? The customer changed. And what changed in the customer? I mean, if you bring to mind a customer that you like the most, that we all have one, if you bring to mind that customer, you may think of that customer and say, okay, that customer did not change his or her habits, or did not change the way that she asks for what she needs. But in reality, what happened is that everything changed, okay? I put an emoji here, and I'm going to call her Karen right now. And Karen, before the COVID, had different interests, had different pain points, had different goals, okay? And we as businesses satisfied those goals or those challenges or those interests. But now, after COVID, Karen changed her spending power and patterns, change her way of consuming, change her pain points, change her challenges, change her interests, change her fears, and change her goals And I'm going to talk about each one of these because I think it's very important for us to understand everything so we can understand now how Karen changed, okay? And Karen can be a corporate, or Karen can be another business, okay? So you as a business, as an entrepreneur, need to understand how your customer changed, because that change is not going to go away. She's not going back to normal. Karen has a new normal. Karen has a new Karen right now. Okay, so spending power and patterns. Maybe Karen lost her job thanks to COVID, or maybe Karen it's only earning half her paycheck thanks to COVID. So her spending power is not the same. She doesn't have the money that she had last year to buy from your business or other businesses. Maybe she has to think about how she's going to spend her money right now. So her spending power changed. But how did that change? Her patterns changed too. Why? Because she doesn't need what she needed a few months ago. She doesn't need maybe to use her car. So what she spent on gas, she's spending it on other things. She doesn't need anymore to go to a gym near her work because she's working at home. So she prefers to work out at home or find a place where she can work out near home. So her spending power and patterns totally changed. Number two, way of consuming. For example, one of my biggest products or services is that I give conferences, and I give conferences with people there, with presence. And something that happens is that now I can't give lectures like that. So right now, everything is through media or through digital tools, okay? So what people is consuming from me, it's all through this thing now that it's called Zoom, that I didn't know before the COVID came and make an entrance. So how did you, or how did Karen in this example, change your way of consuming? Now I'm buying more from Amazon than I did before. I'm using apps that I didn't use before, okay? I make my supermarket list through an app. I don't use Uber anymore, which was one of my most used apps in 2019. I think I use Uber once a month, and I used to use it like twice a day. My way of consuming changed. I'm using Uber right now to send packages to other people who work with me, but not for myself. So yes, I'm using Uber, but I'm not using it as it was meant to use. So they had to put this new product, which I can send packages and they charge a fee so they could deliver, okay? Number three, pain points. What are the pain points? Pain points are those things that are keeping you awake or your customer awake, okay? So the pain points is normally what your customer is motivated to buy. So if he's preoccupied about his kid going to school, he may buy from you a face mask, or he may buy from you whatever you have so his kid or her kid doesn't get infected, okay? So the pain points changed because now we are more interested in health than we were before. Now we are more interested in metrics about our health. We measure our oxygen, we measure our pressure, things that we didn't measure before. So the pain point changed. That's the meaning of that, is that the motivations changed too. Okay? Challenges. Now we have different challenges. Now, people who is working from home have the challenge of communicate and relate to other partners or other colleagues through Zoom or through a phone call, okay? To solve problems through a phone call. So our challenges are totally different as it was 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 months ago. So COVID did change everything. If you take your interests are not the same. Why? Because you are spending more time at home than you did before. So you want to relax, or you want to be entertained, and that cannot happen outside. It has to happen inside your house or with Netflix or any platform that you could think about. Next, fears. Now we are more fearful about our health, our mental health, physical health, emotional health. We are more fearful about our thoughts, about what is going to happen next year, what is going to happen the year after that year, what is going to happen with our lives, with our works. Are we going to lose our jobs? Are we going to keep our jobs? We have different fears. Is someone around me, has the virus? If someone in my work has the virus, what is going to happen? What if I catch the virus? What is going to happen with me? We have different fears that we didn't think about like in January or February, okay? And our goals, we have different goals. We want different things right now. We know we need to improve our health in order to stay healthy and be able, if we catch the virus, be able to survive it. So everything we are thinking as customers has to do with the virus. Everything, Karen, in my example, is thinking right now has to do with the virus. So who is Karen now? She for sure is named Karen too, but who is Karen now? Who is Karen? Who is Karen from her spending power? Who is Karen from her patterns? Who is Karen from her way of consuming, from her pain points, from her challenges? Who is Karen? She's a totally different person as you are right now. You are not buying the same things you bought on January. You are not buying the same things you bought last year. And you totally are not buying the same things this Christmas that you bought last Christmas. Okay? And you have a lot of different reasons. One of them is maybe you can use it. People is not buying a lot of clothes right now. Why? Because you can use it. You're all the time at home and changing a few times a week. Okay? Maybe you just need a few blouses or a few tops, but you don't need that much bottoms. So everything changed. You don't need to be buying the newest tennis on the market because you may not use them at your home. You may be buying pajamas, but that's it. So what Karen is living right now, Karen, my example, your customer and yours, what Karen is living right now is a time of change. And she right now is struggling. And she knows she's struggling. She's not having the best time of her life. Any of us are. Why? Because we are struggling between a lot of things in our heads. Number one, we have a big desire to go out. We want to go out. We want things back as it was. We want to go to the movies. We want to go to the theater. We want to go to dinner without being afraid of contagion. But at the same time, the desire to go out. On the other hand, you have your fear of contagion. What's the fear of contagion? You can go out, but you are always fearing of taking the virus in. Okay? So your desire to go out has his enemy, which is the fear of contagion. And on the other hand, you have the need for recreation and indulgence. We want to have fun. We want to be outside. We want to recreate. We want to connect with other people. But we too have an economic restriction. We don't have as much money to spend as we did last year. And even if we did, we don't want to spend it without thinking about it, because we don't know what's going to happen next year. So, three changes are happening right now in every customer. Number one, we are preferring businesses, shops and companies, and spaces that show evidence of the actions that they are taking to prevent contagion. What does this mean? We want to buy from people who is doing something about us not being near the virus. We want to buy from people who is doing something about the virus and how it is spreading. So, if you're an entrepreneur or want to be an entrepreneur, you have to let know your customer what you are doing to prevent contagion. Where on your website, shows, social media, newsletter if you have, or WhatsApp, whatever communication link you have with your customer has to come with something of evidence that let him know that you are doing something to prevent contagion, okay? Number two, preference for companies that show empathy towards the economic situation caused by the pandemic. We are buying from people that may be affected by the pandemic, but also that is empathetic with us. Okay? We are helping each other. Here's about help. I help you, I buy from you, and what you do is that you may give me a discount or may give me different plans to pay, or may give me more value, or may give me another product or something that has value to me, because you're being empathetic. We are being empathetic. So we want to buy from local shops because they are struggling, but they are helping us too. And we want to help them and be helped, okay? And number three, the constant search for opportunities of recreation, escape, or indulgence that are low cost and low touch. We want to have fun. We want to go out and escape our lives and escape our home from just 1 or 2 or 3 or 5 minutes. We want to relax. We want to relax ourselves and our minds. We want to see another thing that is not our computer or our room or are the same people that we are living with or working with. So we're in constant search of opportunities that help us do that. And they have to be low cost because of the economic restriction, and they have to be low touch. We don't want to be near a lot of people. We don't want to go to the movies. But maybe we can rent a movie from Netflix. And if Netflix is not doing the work anymore, maybe we can buy a theater ticket so we can see a play, and it's something different that we are living on every day, okay? So if your customer has changed her spending or his spending power and patterns, way of consuming, pain points, challenges, interests, fears, and goals, plus they are struggling between the desire to go out and the fear of contagion and the need for recreation and indulgence and the economic restriction, they want to see changes in your business. They want to see changes in what you are doing for them, in how you are serving them, because that's the world we need to have and we need to get in our minds nowadays. It's not about selling anymore. It's about serving. Not selling, serving, okay? Serving our customers through our business. So they want to see these changes. They want to see you do something to prevent contagion. They want to see you being empathetic. They want to see you creating opportunities for recreation, escape, and indulgence, okay? So COVID-19 changed the way business are executed forever. COVID-19 brought with him the word service. We are not buying anymore from bots or from big companies who are not serving us and who doesn't feel human, okay? Because only a human can serve. Only a human can help. A robot, a bot, cannot help. Maybe it can be helpful, but cannot help me. It cannot serve me as a human. So businesses right now are making all their efforts to feel human and to change their execution. So what can we do? Right now, I'll tell you three things that we as entrepreneurs should be resolving for our businesses and for our customers, okay? Number one, and it's about your customer. You have to get to know your customer again. You have to get to know him again. You may have done the work before. You may have got to know him better before, but now he's a totally different customer. He needs different things. What changed? Again, spending power and patterns, way of consuming, pain points, challenges, interests, fears, goals. It's not only that you have their age, name, or where they live. You need to know him better right now. You need to know him during COVID and post-COVID so you can serve him better. So, number one, get to know your customer again. You should be able to answer these questions. How can I help my customer during and post-COVID? How can you help him or help her? She needs help with something, and your business was created to help him resolve a problem. Maybe the problem changed, but you can still help him. For example, and I was talking about it the last lecture, one of my customers, well, a lot of my customers, when I moved from presence to digital lectures, she didn't know, she's in her 60s, and she didn't know how to use Zoom, the platform Zoom, okay? So when I asked her to log in to be on the lecture, she told me that it was impossible for her because she didn't know how to use this platform. And although I tried to explain her through the phone, she didn't know how to use it. And it wasn't easy for her. So what I did was a little video that had the instructions so she could log in and be on the lecture, okay? So I'm helping her develop tools or skills, digital skills, so she can be present at my lectures and she can buy from me, okay? That's not my job? No, it's not my job. I shouldn't be explaining her how to use Zoom, but that's the way I'm helping her, okay? Or if my customers are entrepreneurs, I'm sure giving them a lecture in which I share information about COVID and businesses. Okay, That's the way I'm going to help my customer, so they keep me on top of mind and they keep on buying from me. Number two, what are your audience's main purchasing barriers during and post COVID? And we can use the same example here, because if she doesn't know how to log into Zoom, she's not going to buy from me. If she doesn't know how to pay through PayPal, she's not going to buy from me. So if that's a barrier, I need to eliminate that barrier and make her comfortable buying from me, eliminating that problem. What can I do? A lot of things. I can help her, teach her. And these are only a few examples about this, but you have to think right now why your customer isn't buying. Why your customer don't want to buy from you anymore right now, during and post COVID? And how can you help overcome those problems, those barriers, so he or she can buy and keep on purchasing from your business, okay? And number three, how do your customer interests, fears, goals, pain points, and way of consuming change during and post COVID? Because it is going to change again. You're going to have to do this work a lot of times during this year, next year, and the year after that. Because customer habits and the customers are going to change through this new normal. They have to get along with this new normal. So they are going to adapt to the new normal. And as they adapt, they are going to change. So during COVID, you're having one customer. Post COVID, you're going to have another customer. And after that, you're going to have another customer. Numbers say and pronostics say that COVID is going, the new normal adaptation is going to go as long as December of 2022. Okay, our adaptation is going to begin January 21, and it's going to end December 2022. We haven't even started the adaptation. We haven't even started the new normal. So right now, you have one customer who may be really fearful about the pandemic. And in January, you're going to have another different customer. And on July, you have another different customer. And the January after that, you're going to have another different customer. She and he are going to change, okay? They are going to change because they need to adapt. And in order to adapt, you have to change and embrace change. So yeah, COVID came to change everything. So Maria Catalina says, very interesting. It is super important to develop a real culture of service that should be permanent. Yeah, that's the point. The point is that we want to be served right now, okay? And I don't think this is going to go away. We now know that we have the power again as customers, okay? Number two, about your product. How does your product and service have to change in order to satisfy your customer? And I'm going to repeat this word, satisfy. You have to satisfy your customer right now. One example is Lysol, okay? You know, the antibacterial. Well, Lysol, before COVID, it said it kills 99.99% of bacteria and viruses. Now it says it kills 99.99% of bacteria and viruses, even COVID-19 from surfaces. They didn't change the product. They changed the package. So, how does your product and service have to change in order to satisfy your customer? In Mexico, it happened that people went crazy, hysterical, to just to buy Lysol. They had to change the product. They had to change their package in order to people to keep doing that, to keep buying from them as they were crazy. Okay? So how do you have to change your product or service to keep satisfying them? It's all about your customer. It's not about your ego. Your product may have been super useful last year. That doesn't mean it's going to be useful this year or next year. And it's in your hands and creativity to change it to satisfy your customer. Number three, about your service. How would you go the extra mile? How are you going to give them extra? How are you going to give them more? How are you going to give them that they are not expecting? Some people call them the wow effect, okay? You have to make your customers say wow when they buy from you. I didn't expect this, wow. Your service is pristine, okay? How can you do that? For example, if you are selling skincare products and your product has to be applied after a soap that you can buy from the supermarket, you may put the soap when they buy the product, the skincare product. It may cost you $1. And you have a happy client. Why? Because you're giving more, you're going the extra mile for him. So your customer and you as a customer want to receive more, want the business to go the extra mile for you. So why wouldn't you go the extra mile for your customers? So you have to do the work. You really have to do the work. Why? Because this is not momentary. And it is significant and it is here to stay. It is not going to go away. Let that idea flush on the toilet. Because it's not working for you to think that this is going to go away. It is not going to go away. Now it's as realistic as ever. It is not going to go away. What are you going to do? What are you going to do next year to help your customer adapt to the new normal? And the year after that? And the year after that, what are you going to do? So do the work and wear a face mask. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Hector, for this amazing presentation. It was very interesting to know about these changes. Well, to make conscious about these changes that we are facing right now and how it is very important to have more focus on the service than in the product or service. So now I would like to open a space if anyone has any doubt or question, feel free to write it on the chat or to open the microphone and do it. Well, if there are no questions, thank you once again. And thank you everyone for joining today. We are having the next one at 3 p.m. So we would love to see you there. And thank you so much. Thank you, Hector, and good evening. Bye-bye.
Thanks, bye. Thank you.